As I have already observed on other occasions, it is almost impossible to distinguish the Roman inlays from the early Florentine works, since the tables present in the Medici collections from of old almost always feature Roman characteristics, both in terms of the archaeological marbles used and in the classical style decorations arranged around the prominent central slab. Possibly, although this is merely a theory that I am proposing here for the first time, a table in Palazzo Pitti could be identified as one of the first Florentine inlay. In effect, by omitting the shields and scrolls that are almost never missing in the Roman ornamental repertoire, the simplified design of this table instead enhances the quality of the marbles, dominated by the chromatic contrast between a modern black Belgian marble, little used in Rome, and the rare alabastro listato of archaeological provenance of a vibrant gilded shade. The same combination, although in this case restricted solely to the black and gold color contrast, records in a table that I saw on the Antiques Market, which featured an alabastro listato, apparently deriving from the same piece used for the Pitti table, and where the simplicity of the design appears to be deliberately set off by the incredible thickness, no less than 9 centimeters, of a slab of black Belgian marble that forms the surface, flaunted as a display of exceptional opulence. Works such as these may possibly have been among the early attempts, not technically complex but lavish in materials, of the artisans working for Cosimo I in Palazzo Vecchio workshop, where we know of at least 2 engravers who were active, Michele Di Polo and Bernardino Di Porfirio D'Alleccio. The latter is more than just a name cited in the documents, since he is also known to have created the magnificent tabletop that opens the exhibition, dating to 1557, and one of the first examples of excellence that Florence was to achieve in this field. Designed by Giorgio Vasari for the noted Florentine Bindo Altoviti, it is Vasari himself who tells us that it was the work of Bernardino, who proves himself capable of cutting into articulate shapes the Sicilian jaspers that form the original Moorish decoration, edged with ivory and inlaid on the wooden surface. In the early 1560s, Bernardino was engaged in the production of 2 lost tabletops, again to Vasari's design, one for Cosimo and one for his son Francesco de' Medici. According to the description provided by Vasari, in these tables, art stones were the protagonists of the composition. In this shift in Medici taste from the archaeological marbles of Roman tradition to the pietre dure, we could be tempted to discern the personal influence of Francesco de' Medici, whose passion for splendid art stones was such that in the following decade he had 2 workshops specialized in the intaglio of art stone vases transferred from Milan to Florence. The esoteric geometry of jaspers inlaid on white marble of a table present in Palazzo Pitti is generally cited as practically the only surviving example of Francesco's era and test. It may be possible to add to this an octagonal tabletop, just now unknown, privately owned, where the background slab of marble is inlaid with a rare and varied range of art stones, arranged in a geometrical perspective pattern similar to that of a tabletop of the Museum of Braunschweig, which I described as of Florentine workmanship in my essay for the catalogue of exhibition. I believe that this particular Florentine task can be confirmed by the Intarsia pavement in the Cathedral of Florence, where similar geometrical perspective designs were already being used before the half of the 16th century. We can thus deduce that during the time of Francesco de' Medici, despite sharing the iconic vocation of Roman Intarsia, the Florentine inlay aspired for an autonomous expression inspired by models previously elaborated in Florence, thus confirming the more general rapport between Florentine art of the second half of the 16th century and the local tradition of the first half. Things changed with the arrival in Florence and the ascent to the throne of the Grand Duke of Ferdinando I de' Medici, who succeeded his brother Francesco in 1587. The younger son of Cosimo I, Ferdinando, had been made a cardinal at a very young age and had lived as such in Rome since 1562. Taking full part in the lively intellectual and artistic life of the city and collecting treasures of ancient and modern art in his splendid residence of Villa Medici at Trinità dei Monti. Evidence of Ferdinando's interest in the novelties of Roman inlay and this sophisticated task can be found in two outstanding tabletops that were, in fact, among the furnishing of the Villa Medici. The first is monumental in terms of dimensions and thickness, resembling the magnificence of the tables of the princely Roman families of the time, such as the Farnese Table, now in the collections of the Metropolitan Museum, or that still housed in the Odescalchi collection in Rome. The design can be attributed to the architect Giovanni Antonio Dosio, a Tuscan educated in the Roman taste, who played an important role in spreading the language of the Roman architectural inlay in Florence, as we can see in the Gaddi Chapel in Santa Maria Novella, which be executed in 1575-77. This table, designed by Dosio for Ferdinando de' Medici, offers a variant of architectural scope of the compositional style of the Roman tables in terms of the great, or rather vast in this case, emphasis placed upon the central slab of the Spanish fluorite, the frieze of serried scrolls that runs around the perimeter, and the symmetrical palmettes of classical flower at the extremities of the central oval. The second tabletop, previously in the Villa Medici and on display in the exhibition, is instead unique in respect to the decorative style of Roman inlays known to date, although it too is characterized by a typically Roman culture in the engravings under alabaster that refer to the post-Raphael circle of artists who were active in Rome. Ferdinando returned to Florence as Grand Duke, and in 1588 he founded the artistic manufactory of the court, the driving force both then and later behind the growing popularity of the Florentine mosaic. However, Ferdinando did not abandon the predilection for the archaeological marbles that he had developed in his Roman period. Effectively, if under Francesco I, hard stones appeared to have become the preferred raw material of the Medici passion for beautiful colored stones, during the reign of his brother, who lived until 1609, the marbles and the style of Roman inlay exerted a rather long influence on the creations of the Galleria dei Lavori, as the Caur Manufactory, established by Ferdinando, was called.